Hello from the American Diabetes Association's 73rd Scientific Sessions, the largest diabetes meeting in the world. I'm Anna Baker with another update from Chicago. We have exciting news about the future of the artificial pancreas. This is the long sought-after device that combines an insulin pump with software and sensors to manage blood glucose levels on a continuous basis, mimicking the organ that doesn't work well in people with diabetes. We just heard about a major advance that reduces the risk of dangerously low blood glucose levels overnight. Hypoglycemia is critical because it can lead to unconsciousness, seizures, and even death. And overnight hypoglycemia is a particular concern for most patients with type 1 diabetes and their families. Right here in Chicago, researchers reported that an insulin pump can actually be programmed to temporarily shut off when blood glucose levels dip too low. The study showed that this feature would reduce the occurrence of nighttime hypoglycemia by 26% and its duration and severity by 38%. The device does this by shutting off insulin delivery for 2 hours once glucose levels dip below a certain threshold, usually 70 milligrams per deciliter. Though the pump turns off automatically, it can be manually overridden if you wake up and want to drink some juice to raise your blood glucose levels rather than wait for them to return to normal. And if you don't wake up, insulin delivery automatically restarts after the 2 hour period. This feature is part of the MiniMed 530G system, which is made by Medtronic. The device is already available internationally and is currently undergoing review by the US Food and Drug Administration. The diabetes world has had its eye on the artificial pancreas for a long time, and this smart pump technology feature is a key step in the development of a fully automated artificial pancreas for people with diabetes. So what's next? Researchers and developers will continue to refine the shutoff and restart mechanism of insulin to prevent hypoglycemia during the day. And then they will program the pump to safely add more insulin when blood glucose levels go too high. Eventually, they hope the pump will be able to adjust insulin and maybe other hormones to control levels all day long, even during mealtimes and exercise. This will even more closely resemble the workings of a real pancreas. I'm Anna Baker with your breaking news update from the American Diabetes Association's Scientific Sessions in Chicago. To view this press release online, please visit the For Media section of our website, diabetes.org. And for the latest video coverage from the meeting, stay tuned to diabetes.org/breakingnews.